that's fucking hilarious.
What was that?
Jimmy Cabs has a healthy glow.
Yeah, send me a message telling me what a healthy glow I have, and you get a pair of tickets courtesy of Hate War Productions. All right.
That diabetes makes you shine.
Oh, boy. Hey, Scott.
Yes,
Jimmy. If Cryptic Slaughter was doing music collectively now,
mm-hmm.
do you ever think about what direction you would have been in now? Because the band had kind of like metamorphosized from like an early death metal to like a political crossover punk.
Yeah.
And then do you think about like where it would be now?
I'm sure we would still have the speed because that's what people would expect. But I think you could probably take like the slower songs off of Money Talks and kind of like where we went with Stream, even though the production sucked ass. You know, the songs were really, there's more tempo changes and not just blistering fast.
Mm-hmm.
I think we would have gone more that way, but we still would have had the speed just because that's what, you know, what we were known for, and you know, you can't get rid of that.
I know.
That's just like, you know.
We were talking about another band where in the year, we won't mention that during the early 90s, they went from that hardcore, you know, really iconic sound of that era, and then like in the 90s, they did some smashing pumpkins fucking thing in it.
Yeah. You know, it's, you gotta remember where you come from. You know, it's just the bottom line. It's like, and if you wanna do different types of music, then do a side band.
Yeah.
But if your band's known for something, just, and it's doing well, just stick with it. Just do that. But, you know, it's not, there's nothing wrong with growing in music, but also, you know, you gotta realize that if you're playing thrash or crossover, you know, you can make a decent living, I'm sure, doing it. And it's good to branch out, but at the same time, stay true to what got you there. That's my only 2 cents.
Do you still stay relevant to today's extreme underground music? Are you still in touch with today's extreme underground, like the black metal or death metal or the genres that mutated after? Because I mean, when we were around in the early 80s, these genres didn't exist.
No, and
it was Venom.
Yeah, or Bathory, or Sodom, or Creator. You know, and that's, I pretty much with music at the age I'm at, you know, I always keep my ear open for something that I like if it's new. But I always go to all reliable. Like, if I want to hear black metal, I'm going to put on, you know, Welcome to Hell by Venom. Or, you know, if I want to hear punk rock, I'm going to put on City Baby's Revenge.
Nice.
You know,
the classics.
Yeah, the classics. But I mean, it's like, you know, but, you know, there's bands like Slayer, which I still to this day are one of my favorite bands. Like, I cannot go a day without listening to Slayer.
Can you picture bands of our era doing like what the Rolling Stones are doing, like being 60s, almost 70s, still young? Can you picture like Slayer being 60 doing what they're doing?
I think they're going to get close to it. I don't think they're going to get that far, but I think, you know, I mean, but who would have thought like Slayer would be doing sign up places that they are now?
That's crazy.
I mean, we used to go see them at, you know, Radio City out in Anaheim and the Country Club, and like, I bought my first Slayer shirt off Dave Lombardo right before Hunting the Chapel EP came out.
Incredible.
You know, and I met him and I told him that story. He goes, "Wow, you've been with us a long time." I'm all, "Yep, I'm old, dude."
I told Kerry King a long time ago, not to stray off the subject, but I told Kerry King a long time ago, "You know what? You better send my friends, give them an autograph, because I paid for that house in Arizona, dude, with all the merch."
I'm sure he loved to hear that from you.
No, he didn't.
Yeah.
Hey, Black Monday, you got a video coming out?
Yes.
Talk to me about that.
It's for one of our kind of more rockin' songs, I guess you can call it, more kind of dirty rock and roll song called Shot to Hell. It was shot by our bass player's brother, Marco, who does all our videos, and our bass player, Rusty, and his brother, Marco, do all our videos.
Great videos, man.
Yeah, I mean, well, they both have great eyes. Like, all the visual Black Monday stuff is done by Rusty, and all the photography is done by his brother, and they have it down pat, and they do such an awesome job that, you know, part of being in a band nowadays, you know, is the image, and they take the Black Monday image and what we want and make it come to life, which is, it's great to be in a band and be working with those people.
You look happy as fuck in that band too, man.
Oh, dude, I mean, how could it go wrong playing with, you know, three great guys who are fucking some of my best friends.
Bunch of hot chicks
playing,
in the audience.
Playing music and, you know, people enjoying it, and just, it's, you know, so the video's gonna be called Shot to Hell, and, you know, it's when it comes out, every dude will love it. That's all I can say. It's a great dirty song that your chick will fucking love to dance to, but the video will make every dude go fucking play that again. That's all I'm gonna say. Because we're old purrs, man. You know, we know what we want to see. We don't.
Yeah,
they don't want to see me.
Yeah, yeah. I mean, listen. I think you're cool and everything, but I like how you tend to fixate on certain certain physical parts of the females. That's what keeps me interested.
See,
how can people get a hold of the Black Monday EP?
The Black Monday EP will be on iTunes either the next month or the beginning of January.
Great EP, dude. I love it.
Thank you very much. And I mean, you know, we're on Facebook, so Black Monday, or if you want to go to blackmonday2.com, that's our website. We have put in Black Monday in YouTube. We have our YouTube channel. You can see, you know, the videos we've made, and you know, it's good to keep playing music. It keeps me young.
Yeah, man. You know what? I want to thank you for being here. You've heard it. Cryptic Slaughter reunion is not happening ever.
Nope. Maybe in store, but no live performances.
You know what? I want to thank you for being here and for letting us flash back a little bit. When are you playing again with Black Monday?
This Thursday at Spikes in Rosemead we are playing, and then December 14th at Mr. T's Bowl in Highland Park.
All right. Make sure you get out there and see Black Monday. See Scott Peterson. Still bashing those drums, man.
Yeah, you know, I'm still my speed. I'm still, you know, not as fast, but I'm still there. I still got some gas underneath, you know, in the gas tank, whatever you want to call it.
All right. Thanks for being here, Scott.
Thanks
man.
For having me, man.
Really
it's an absolute
it.
Pleasure. Thanks for going down memory lane.
Absolutely. Let's listen to another track off Black Monday here. This is Jimmy Cabs. Say farewell. Thank you for listening. And I'm going to leave you with another quote. Really, I think this is appropriate. This is from, how do you pronounce this, Lil Johnny?
Friedrich Nietzsche.
Without music, life would be a mistake. That is so true.
So true.
All right. You're listening to KEC. Thank you for listening. See ya.